Hi guys, Sharon here. Today I'm going to be talking about Aspen Kay's Fugly soap. So this is the second package I got. The first package that I had was the Dead Sea Mud and Charcoal one. And the one that I have here today that I'm going to talk about is the Oatmeal Milk and Honey. Just like the other one, you can see that these, I have two bars left in the package. There was a 1 pound bag and there were about six bars. And so you can see they are a bit different in size. This is about half the size of this one, but they are still normal sizes, like similar to what a normal size bar of soap is. I really don't mind the fact that these are ugly or banged up or anything. These were about half the price of what I would have paid had I bought the same amount of soap in the normal bars. So Aspen Kay Naturals is a small niche company. At the time when I bought it about a year ago, they had only soap and soap holders. And I do prefer to buy and support companies that are either small or that have a small amount of products, a limited number of products. I feel like there are so many big conglomerates out there. It's nice to support the little guys as long as they're doing things safely. Some companies do not, unfortunately. And I also prefer when they have a limited number of products, I feel like they can invest more into those products rather than having huge variety. The quality can just vary, and also I get overwhelmed by choice. So the ingredients in here, unfortunately, they do not follow the INCI standards. I did buy this a while ago, and I don't know if the standards were enacted when I bought that, when I bought this. But here are the ingredients. They use words that they shouldn't, such as organic and sustainable. So the first ingredient is organic sustainable palm oil. I know some people are wary of palm oil. There is the RSPO, and supposedly they get their palm oil from there. Coconut oil, that is not organic. Organic shea butter, organic sunflower oil, organic olive oil, organic castor oil, organic oats, organic honey, goat's milk, organic cocoa powder, fragrance, and sodium hydroxide. They do have a mistake in their label, goat's milk, and they also have fragrance. Their fragrance is phthalate free. So a lot of people are scared of fragrance. Because of the phthalates. So you will see if you follow the EWG, things with fragrance, you should get a 7 to 9. And more people are moving towards essential oils because they're natural. The problem with this way of thinking, so these two bars, so this one, the Dead Sea Mud, has essential oils, and this one has fragrance, but it is phthalate-free. Essential oils are not safe for everybody. There are certain populations, such as children, people with pre-existing medical conditions, or people on certain medications, who should not be using essential oils. This bar, in fact, has some essential oils that are not safe for children, so I will not use this on my kids. My daughter, one of my daughters, had a bad reaction to essential oils. Her face got swollen, her lymph nodes in her neck got swollen, she had a rash, a head-to-toe rash, that got, like I literally could see spreading before my eyes. And she spiked a high fever. We took her to the doctor. They actually gave her some medicine to prevent her throat from closing because we just didn't know what was going on, and she got a whole bunch of other medications. Her reaction, her allergic reaction, did go away quickly, but it is quite scary to see something happen to your child with something that's natural. And now I am a lot more careful with essential oils on what I diffuse and what I use with my kids. I do kind of prefer not to use essential oils that much, especially in products that are already made. So I have no idea what the dilution rate of the essential oils is in this. Sometimes if you get things made, like with Etsy, you can request that they use the correct dilution rates with children. Otherwise, I am trying to stay away from essential oils. So this, this does use artificial fragrance. But it does have, it is phthalate free. Some of the ingredients in here, this has, I know you can't see it, but as you use the soap, you do expose the oats. And the oats that they use, it's not collodial oats, collodial oatmeal, which is the finely ground powder. It is literally, I'm going to show you it because I brought some here. It is literally just rolled oats. This did not come from the soap. This is just, so in here they literally are using rolled oats. And I know oatmeal is good for your skin. It's supposed to be very good for your skin. Unfortunately, I feel like they should have ground these up or something, because they can, if you have drains that clog, I feel like this is not the best option available. So I do, however, I do like the company. I do like the idea behind the company. I do like that they're selling Fugly soap. And also the fact that they have an option for you to be able to have soap that doesn't have essential oils for some people who are not able to use essential oils. But I will not buy this particular product again. And the reason is simply because if they have oats, I feel like it's going to clog my drain. I don't have a very good drain. So if you think this is something that you are interested in, please take a look at Aspen Kay, and look at their Fugly soaps, and you can look at their normal soaps as well. And I'm going to place a link in the description so you can see where I got it from. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Be sure to like and turn on notifications so you get the latest content. Bye.